Hey, Kamsan, it's B. I'm hoping you're not all completely done with Halloween and parties and stuff. Because today I thought I was going to show you how to really simply do Bruce makeup or like beat up makeup. So I'm going to show you how to do this with products that you probably have at home, which makes this a super easy makeup to do for Halloween. But as you can probably see, I've already started with like my base makeup, which is like my everyday makeup, so it's just like a foundation and some eyeliner and like eyebrows and stuff. So it's not like anything super advanced. So I just do that first, and then when starting with the bruises, I like to think like where on the face, because we're gonna focus on the face. I think about where on the face is it like realistic that a bruise could be, and like the size of the bruising and stuff like that. I think what I'm gonna focus on today, I'm gonna do like try to do a black eye, and then do some on like the cheekbone, and some I think I'm gonna try to do something like around the mouth and the nose. Yeah, so I'm gonna start with doing the black eye, and I'm gonna do it on my left eye. So what I'm gonna do, I'm mostly just gonna use eyeshadow for this actually. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with a red eyeshadow, and I'm using my trusty eyeshadow palette that if you have watched my videos for like pretty much all of the time I've done videos, this is the palette that I've used. It's like 100 colors or something, which is great for cosplay because you use a lot of colors. So I'm gonna start with this red one, which is, it looks like really pigmented. But the thing, you know, that you need to think about when you're doing bruises is, depending on like how like big or how, yeah, like how big they are and like how they came to be and like in which state of the healing process they are, they're gonna shift in different colors. Like for a very fresh bruise, it would be darker, like blues and reds. But for a bruise that is a couple of days old, that has healed a bit, then it's gonna shift more into the yellows, lighter blues, and greens. But we want to get a really dramatic look, so therefore I'm gonna work a lot with blue and reds to get a more purple, really like bruised color. So starting with some red on a pencil, a like slightly bigger pencil, so which is better for application. So I'm gonna start slightly dabbing it on in like the corner, and also bringing it down underneath my eye a little bit. And bringing it up. Be careful to not use too much product to make it, like we don't want it to look too fake. Then what I usually do, sometimes when just instead of using a blending brush, I just use my finger. And like always when doing makeup or cosplay or whatever, use references. So if you want like a natural looking black eye, look up pictures of black eyes. So we want, for like a black eye, we want the focus to be underneath the eye. So I'm gonna stay in like the crease and work it down. So yeah, what you want to do is take blue next. And I'm using a blue from Wet n Wild in this palette. I'm using this, the darkest one, but I'm using like very lightly to not get a like really, really blue. So you take that and you put it under your eye, and I follow like my dark circle to get it to look pretty natural. Then I also put some under the eye here, and just like, to make it join, and I pull it up towards my eyebrow and mix it together with the red. to get more of a bruised purplish color. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this dark pink, this right here, and I'm gonna like take it above the blue and make sure it's not too like extremely dramatic. And the next thing I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take a yellow, and I'm gonna use this bright yellow here, and I'm gonna use it like in the edges and the empty spaces, because that's usually something that happens, like in the ends, or yeah, the edges of the bruises is usually somewhat like yellow tones, but also like mixing it in a bit more with the others. I'm trying to make it not like be too yellow, so we can use a shade a little bit wider too. Okay, so I'm feeling pretty satisfied with the eye for now, so I'm gonna go ahead and do some other bruises. So as I said, I'm thinking doing one here on my cheekbone, and the like general idea is pretty much just the same thing with the colors, but then you just think about, you know, a different shape and how it would like affect the face. So once again, I'm starting with a red. And then we go over it with the blue in places. See, using a darker blue makes it like a more fresh, more bigger, dramatic bruise. So if you don't want that, use a lighter blue. And like I said, use references, look at pictures of bruises. If you want to do a more healed bruise, then you want to do other colors. And like I said, like right now I have a huge bruise on my leg, which is a couple of days old at this point, so it's usually, or it's mostly just yellow and some green, but for makeup I like using the more dramatic ones to make them really stand out. And if you're doing something like Halloween, you're gonna want to have your bruises show. Dabbing on the color I think helps with getting it to look more natural, nice shape and spread. Alright, I feel pretty like done with the reds and the blues on this one. So I'm gonna start dabbing on some yellow on the corners, like I did with the black eye. So, once again, using the same yellow, so I'm actually going between these two, because sometimes this is a little too strong yellow, and then you want a lighter shade, so I'm using both of them. I'm taking the stronger yellow, pulling it up into the bruise more. So something like that I think will be enough actually. So now we're gonna go ahead and do the nose, because I'm gonna do like some scratches on the nose later. So I want to do just, you know, crossing over the nose, something small, just some red with like a tiny bit of blue and some yellow is my idea at this point. So once again, taking the same red, I'm dusting it off a little bit. And then doing across my nose, something like this, and then just doing like slight tiny pieces of blue. Don't want it a lot. I want the focus to be on the scar and not the bruise on the nose. Something like that for the nose I think will be just fine. And then just rounding it off and finishing it off. I also want to do some like scars on the lip. So I'm just going to do like some red to make it more of a scar than a bruise look. Okay, so moving on to the scratches, which is something I like to use to just make the makeup come more alive. If you want to do just, you know, beaten up makeup, this is fine. You can stop here if you want to, but I like having a few like scratches in there to make it more alive. And then I just use an old paintbrush, and this is actually really good to use for this. And what you want is a like hard paintbrush. I mean, it's not hard, but the brush hair is like hard. You know, there is, if you were to like, I don't have another paintbrush here, but if you were to compare it to another brush, these are like more softer, whereas this is kind of hard. So you want this one to get the right look. I'm using a red lipstick, like a kind of creamy one, so what you want to do is take the brush and like apply some lipstick so you have it on the ears. And then you want to put on where you want the scratches to be. And the hairs of the brush will make the lipstick look like tiny scratches. I don't know if you can see any better here, otherwise I will post pictures of it later so you can see it better. And then I'm gonna go ahead and make some scratches on this big one here. Completes the look. I added some fake blood in a few places. Otherwise, this has been a really easy tutorial on how to make bruises with products that you probably already have at home if you're a person who does makeup. So I hope that you all have a fun and safe Halloween, and if you attempt this makeup, I would love to see it. So send me your pictures. All my social medias are down below. And I'll see you in